In this video, we're computing the integral of x times sinh of x, where sinh is the hyperbolic sine function, and this is a definite integral. And we're going to use integration by parts for this. I have this extra factor of x tacked onto the integrand, and the derivative of x becomes simpler. So we're going to let u equal x, and then the rest of this integral, we're going to let dv equal sinh x dx, and that has a guessable antiderivative. So we let u equal x, and this means that du is equal to dx. We let dv equal sinh x dx, and the antiderivative of the hyperbolic sine function is just the hyperbolic cosine function, cosh of x. So we apply integration by parts, and the first term in this is going to be u times v, so x times hyperbolic cosine or cosh x, evaluated from 0 to 1. And then we have minus the integral from 0 to 1 of v du, and that's just cosh x dx. We're leaving the first term alone for now. And the integral of cosh is just sinh. So now we can think about evaluating across the limits of integration. And in the first term, I noticed that when I sub in the lower limit, I definitely get 0 because x is 0 out in front of that term. So I end up with a cosh of 1 from that first term. Then in my lower limit, when I sub in x equals 1, I get a sinh of 1. And I subtract what I get by subbing in x equals 0. And the double negative gives me a plus sinh of 0. And I actually want to simplify this whole answer by going back to the definitions of cosh and sinh and getting everything expressed in terms of e. So there's the definition of the cosh function. It's 1/2 times the quantity e to the x plus e to the negative x. This is actually the even part of the function e to the x, and I'll post a link to the video where I showed that. And there's sinh of x, and this is not surprisingly the odd part of e to the x, and that's in the same video. And now I can evaluate what cosh of 1 is, so I can express everything in terms of e. So I imagine putting in x equals 1 into both of these exponents, and that gives me an e to the 1 plus an e to the negative 1. In other words, I have a 1/2 e plus 1 over e. Then I subtract the sinh of 1, giving me a 1/2 e minus 1 over e for the sinh of 1. And then I have to add to this the sinh of 0. But when I sub in x equals 0 into the sinh function, I get e to the 0, which is 1 for the first term, minus e to the 0, which is 1 for the second term. So sinh of 0 vanishes. Now I start cleaning things up, and when I distribute the 1/2 to each term for each of these, I end up with a 1/2 e minus 1/2 e. So those terms are gone. And I end up with a 1 over 2 e plus another 1 over 2 e. And this gives me a grand total of 1 over e. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.